Okay, please be attentive, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Today we are going to start our lesson about economic systems. System means when we say computer is a system. Why do we say it is a system? Because different parts of that computer, they work with each other in order to achieve their common objectives. What are those parts which are working in a system or in a computer? They are hard drive, processor, RAM, and they are connected to each other and they are provided the inputs, they are displaying the output. Alright? So in any system we find that when parts are integrated, they work with each other, then they can achieve or they can perform their tasks. Same is the case in the case of economic system. We have the economic agents. What are those economic agents? Economic agents, we find them. One is called consumers. Second is called producers. And third one is the government. So when these economic agents, they're working with each other, they're working together, so they are having one of the economic system, either to follow. There are different economic systems. One is called free market economic system, another is called brand economic system, and the last one is called the mixed economic system. So when they work with each other, they are going to answer the basic economic questions. What are the basic economic questions? What to produce, how to produce, and for whom to produce. So these economic systems are also given another name, that is called allocative mechanism. Economic system of allocative mechanisms. Allocative mechanism. What do you mean by this word? That these economic systems are going to allocate resources. What are the resources? Scarce resources, land, labor, capital, in order to produce the goods and services to overcome the basic economic problem of scarcity. Alright? Allocative mechanism or economic system means what? These economic systems will answer the basic economic questions, what, how and for whom to produce, in order to overcome the basic economic problem of scarcity. That cannot be completely overcome. But the thing is that we have to fulfill maximum of human wants within given resources or limited resources, which are also having alternate uses. Okay, now what is the free market economic system? Free market means it is not having any government intervention. Government is not playing its role. In case of free market system, listen, these two, consumers and producers, they are deciding, they are answering what to produce, how to produce and for whom to produce. In other words, free market means the market forces or demand and supply will answer what goods should be supplied, what goods should be produced and how their cost of production should be minimized and for whom to be produced. All the basic economic questions, they will be answered by consumers and producers or by the market forces of demand and supply. Consumer forces called demand, whereas producer forces called supply. Free means this system is not having any type of government restrictions, government intervention is not there. Market forces of demand and supply. Okay? Consumer force is called demand, whereas producer force is called supply. So whatever the goods are demanded, they are shown in the market. So producers are looking at the market signals. Like during the pandemic season, what was in demand more? Masks were more demand. So producers, they started to produce these masks locally rather to have the imports of these masks. So when market is showing that this is going to be demanded by the consumers, producers will be allocating resources to produce those items. Without any government intervention, government did not ask any producer to supply masks. Alright? So, producers of different farms, they started to supply masks because they were in high demand. And many of the medicines which are related to this COVID-19, they were also produced around the globe because they are now in high demand. So, when these economic questions, they are answered by the market forces of demand and supply or by consumers and producers without any government intervention, that economic system is called free market economic system. And when these basic economic questions, what, how and for whom to produce, they are only answered by the government. This is what free market economic system. And when government is only going to answer what to produce, how to produce and for whom to produce, then it is called a planned economic system. What it is? Planned economic system. Now the government is the central decision maker to decide what things have to be produced, what consumer wants are there, what consumer needs are there. So what to produce, how to produce, they are assessed and planned by the government. There is the central decision making method. In case of free market economy, we have decentralized decisions. There is no central command by the government to produce these goods to the producers in case of free market economy. But in case of planned economy, what is happening? Government is commanding, government is giving the central decision making to its farms to produce these types of goods. Goods are planned by the government, what to produce, how to produce and for whom to produce. Now mixed economic system is that in which, because both free market and planned economic systems, they are having the problems. They are unable to overcome the basic economic problem of scarcity effectively. In some ways, free market economy was not producing the public goods, it was not having more of merit goods. And planned economy was not producing qualitative goods. Yes, there is a time lag as well. And again, we are facing a problem that they are not producing qualitative products, they are only focusing on quantity produced. So for that reason, we have a mixed economic system. So what are not covered by free market or planned economic system, they can be better supplied by the mixed economic system. Alright? So when we have the mixture of both free market and planned economic systems, and we find that it is a mixed economic system where the basic economic questions are answered both by the market. Majority of the decisions will be taken by the private producers and consumers, whereas if market is absent or it is having allocated inefficiency, then government will be playing its role to provide those goods and services. So this is about the introduction. Now one by one we are going into the detail of each system, that how these systems are working. Now come towards the free market economic system, what it is. Here, what will be the definition? Definition is that this market system, free market system, will answer the basic economic questions by the market forces of demand and supply without any government intervention. The basic economic questions, basic economic questions, are answered by the market forces of demand and supply. Market forces of demand and supply. Without any government intervention, without any government intervention. That's why we say it is free market economy. We can also give it a name like capitalism. Capitalist societies are those where capitalists, they are deciding what for whom to produce. Basically, the capital owners. Now, what are the characteristics? It is having private ownership. What do we mean by private ownership? That the individuals can own their private businesses, properties. They are the owners of their services, their properties and businesses. This can be a motivation for the free market economic system. So we say private ownership means this economic system encourages the ownership of private goods, private businesses, private services, private properties. There is no limit how much you can own. There is no limit. If you are having one farm to produce the goods and services, you can have more than one. If you are having one house in order to live in, you can have more than one house. Alright? There is no restriction. Actually, this is going to have the motivation. Motivation to the producers and consumers to increase their private ownerships. Everyone is working to increase the private ownership. Here we find invisible hand shading. What it is? Invisible hand shading. What do you mean by invisible? Which cannot be seen. Like you are the students, you are here to maximize your learning welfare. Want to learn the things in all the subjects, and we people are here to maximize our earnings. We are provided the salaries. So this invisible hand theory says every individual in the society is having the maximizing behavior. What I said, everyone in the society is having maximizing behavior. Like consumers, they are maximizing their satisfaction after consuming the goods. Be attentive now. What consumers are maximizing? They are maximizing their satisfaction. Whenever you are studying over here or you are consuming something, you are maximizing your satisfaction. If you are able to understand the thing, that means you are quite satisfied to learn these subjects. This is what invisibly consumers are behaving to maximize their welfare. What producers are maximizing?
Their profit.
Mm-hmm. When both consumer and producer, they are having this maximizing attitude and they are living in the same society, it means the welfare of the whole society is also maximized. When all of you are living in the same society, some of you are the producers and others are consumers. So when everyone is maximizing his own welfare or her own welfare, the welfare of society will be maximized. This is actually the invisible hand, the maximizing behavior. This is the maximizing behavior which is present in the society in order to increase their private ownership. This is motivational force that we should be maximizing our welfare. I am here to earn, so I want to maximize my earnings. You are here to learn, so you want to maximize your learning because you are paying for this type of work. In other words, everyone is having selfish attitude in order to maximize his personal welfare. So when everyone is maximizing personal welfare, the welfare of whole society will also be maximized. Follow my points or not? Now, another thing which is present in this free market economic system, what is that?
Sir, is
that
private ownership
system? We are company welfare maximizing the way we are saying over the 19 grams of welfare for it. If in industry, say, go over the 19 grams. तो आपकी अपने This is my meaning. Alright. Second point is that आप इसको कह रहे हैं एक और इसमें निकाल दें motivational forces maximizing gain. People are motivated in order to maximize their personal welfare. Government is not imposing to have these types of goods. Government is not instructing to the producers and consumers. So this is their own personal welfare. How are they able to maximize? And the second thing that is no government intervention. No government intervention. What do you mean? Government is not playing any economic role in this free market economy. Government is having the legislative role. Government is looking after the economic activities. What types of goods the producers are producing, either merit goods or demerit goods, government has nothing to do with. Government is playing no role at all. So first thing, private ownership. Second thing, legislative. They are making the rules only for the whole country, but their government is not becoming the producer of anything. Government is not providing job opportunities to the people. So what private markets, they are deciding what, how and for whom to produce. So all the decisions, third, all decisions are made on decentralized decisions are made. Decentralized. Decision making. Decisions are. Government is having no role to make the decisions in the economic system. Alright? So, what we say, private ownership and the motivational force is that self welfare maximization of the people, no government ownership. So, resources can be allocated to produce those goods which are high in demand by the consumers and they can increase the consumer welfare. Okay? So, this system is working. So, in this case, what will be the outcomes of this system? What are the outcomes? First outcome is that consumer sovereignty. What do we mean by sovereign? Consumer is the king of the whole system. If he or she is satisfied by the products they are consuming, then producers will be serving better to the consumers, because if consumers are satisfied, ultimately the profit of the sellers will also be maximized. And if consumers are unsatisfied by the products supplied by the producers, then definitely there will be no way to earn profit by the producers. So what things will be supplied by the producers which will satisfy the consumers? So basically the whole system revolves around the consumer satisfaction. If you visit any of the consumer area like KFC or Pizza Hut, you can find over there the best customer services provided by them. Because they know if this coming consumer is satisfied, they will come again. And ultimately profit can be maximized. Alright? So this is the main thing. What consumers are willing to buy, that will be supplied. Second, it will promote competition and efficiency. Do you know? Everyone in this economic system will compete in the market to best satisfy the consumers. So they will try to minimize their cost of production. So when cost is minimized, we say they are achieving economic efficiency. So due to competition, customers are having more choices to buy the goods. Quality of goods will also be improved. More variety of goods are available, more choices are there, and due to more efficiency and competition, prices can also be decreased, more economic goods can also be available, and they have more quality, better quality. Therefore, the lifestyle or living standard of people can also be improved due to competition and efficiency. Okay? So, can I say there is a carrot and stick rule? carrot and stick rule. What do you mean by this? Carrot and stick rule का meaning ये है. Carrot denotes rewards. Carrot denotes rewards and stick denotes punishment. What do you mean? Market will reward those producers who are able to compete and they are efficient. Then market will be rewarding those people, those producers in the form of high profits. Those who are able to compete and they are efficient as well to reduce their per unit cost of production. Therefore, market will be having more rewarding opportunities for those who are able to compete. And what do you mean by stick? Stick means the punishment. Those who are unable to compete and they are inefficient, market will punish them and those producers will be out of the market. They cannot survive if they are unable to compete in the market. Okay? If they are not adopting the changes in the market conditions, then they cannot survive. Okay? Now what else can be there? More of the luxury goods are produced. What else are produced? Luxury means beautification of lives. More qualitative and luxury goods are produced. We can say more luxurious goods. Goods are produced and qualitative as well. You can find that we are having immense competition in the cellular phone supplies. We can have Samsung, we can have iPhones. So what we are finding, they are beautifying the lives of their users by having more better quality and luxury products in the market. So that will improve the quality of life of people as well. Their living standard can also be improved because they are having more variety and qualitative and luxury products which are produced. Alright? So this system is actually benefiting the consumers and producers. Alright? In this way. There are the other drawbacks or disadvantages of this system. What are the disadvantages if I ask you? Yes. First is more of demerit goods are produced. Demerit goods are those like wine and cigarettes. They are either harmful to the consumers, but they are highly profitable as well. So producers, they are maximizing their welfare. Although their aim is to maximize profit, but at the cost of the consumer health. Okay?
So
third is necessities are less supplied. and they are very expensive as well. Necessities are less produced and they are very expensive as well. Okay, we find this thing, these are the disadvantages of free market system. Another thing, unequal distribution of income. Unequal distribution of income. Kya matlab hai iska? The gap between
rich and poor is increasing.
Yes. The gap between rich and poor will increase. Alright? The rich is becoming more and more rich and poor is becoming more poor. The gap between rich and poor will be widening. So this system, although it is good enough to have more consumer satisfaction, more goods are produced, more competition is here, but due to these things it is having disadvantages due to decentralized decision making and free economy to the producers available to produce whatever they want to maximize their profits. And consumers will also be involved in more of the developments. Okay? So, because of this unequal distribution of income, the gap between rich and poor will be widening. So, later on, a new system was developed. Although it is natural in its working, a new system was developed by Karl Marx with the name of planned economic system or socialism or communism. So they gave us one motivation to have equal distribution of income in the society. We'll be doing in our next class about planned and mixed economic system, and then our topic of economic systems will be concluded, and we are approaching towards the end of this chapter as well.